Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Shaniqua Vereen. This week, we're celebrating the Olympic spirit on the International Space Station as the Expedition 71 crew gets into the games. More on that in a moment, but first, we'll take a look at the latest crew heading to the space station. On Friday, July 26, NASA SpaceX Crew 9 was given the green light to proceed with a mid-August launch. After a series of successful Starlink launches, Crew 9 will launch atop a Falcon 9 rocket at the Florida Cape in just a few weeks.
For me, coming from a scientific background, I'm actually very much looking forward to doing research that's very interdisciplinary, very integrated, and is at varying levels of technological readiness. Some of it is very fundamental research. Some of it is more of a technology demonstration. A lot of the science that we'll be doing is actually research on ourselves, things like effects on our vascular system, on our genetics, are very similar to aging populations and immunocompromised populations on Earth, and a lot of the research that we will be doing therefore helps people on the ground.
Base to ground.
The Expedition 71 crew embraced the Olympic spirit with a unique display of team spirit and athleticism in zero gravity. A new video shows crew members engaged in weightless versions of track and field events, as well as other creative challenges designed to test their skills in microgravity. It's a fun reminder that the Olympic spirit can reach all corners of the Earth and beyond. In addition to the Olympic fun, we look forward to a new cargo craft to deliver new science to the space station. Saturday, August 3rd, Northrop Grumman's 21st resupply mission is set to launch from Cape Canaveral Space Force Station and will deliver over 8,500 pounds of critical research materials and supplies aboard the Cygnus spacecraft. Flying aboard Cygnus are tests of water recovery technology and a process to produce stem cells in microgravity, studies of the effects of spaceflight on microorganism DNA and liver tissue growth, and live science demonstrations for students. And that's a wrap for this week's Space to Ground. Thank you for joining us.